Next question is from Lean Queen. How can I alleviate or prevent muscle knots? I get persistent knots on my legs, including on my psoas and the back of my knees, which are very painful to work out. The knots seem to get worse after exercise and better after a hot bath.
You know, what makes a muscle knot, or, you know, when you feel someone's massaging you and you feel like a knot and they push on it real hard and then all of a sudden it goes away. Mm-hmm. What causes a knot or what a knot is, there's a little bit of controversy.
Have they come to any conclusion with that?
Yeah, here's what the most common theory is, and that's the one I believe is as well. Obviously, your muscles contract or relax, and that's controlled largely by the central nervous system. And I do think that when your body is used in a way that's unbalanced, or you're dehydrated, lots of stress, or you have poor mobility, that in order to protect itself, your CNS puts some muscles under a slight, almost like it's sending a small signal to it, and it's putting it under a little bit of a flex. You know, like if your shoulder mobility is poor and you don't have muscles that support your shoulder girdle well, right, your CNS will turn on your upper traps a little bit to stabilize. So then when people come push on your neck, you're like, oh my God, I'm so tight. Now, why does it feel good to press on it? Because pressing on a muscle, just like stretching a muscle, eventually tells the central nervous system
to relax.
And then you feel that release. Oh, the knot is totally gone. So massage is good. Foam rolling is good. Not the solution. Those are all temporary Band-Aids. The solution is improve your movement patterns. Focus on mobility. If you have not been on our MAPS Prime Pro webinar, it's free. Go on there. Adam teaches it, so you know it's a good job. And you learn good mobility moves for a lot of the body that'll solve what's causing knots in the first place.
Yeah, I wonder too if it's a constant repetitive usage sort of a signal too, like where they used to call it overactive muscles.
There you go. I was gonna make the statement that I don't think that the science has been wrong on this. I think with the way we have explained it, yes, for so many years, yeah, because I learned it as overactive, underactive muscles, right? This, yeah, is an overactive muscle, mm-hmm, to your where you're going right now.
Right, yeah. No, and that's so I have been paying attention too, and I'm trying to see where they conclude, because there is a lot of like debate around all this, but it makes sense to me to that, like you're producing the signal that I'm doing these patterns over and over and over again, and you know, the body's sort of trying to warn, like, okay, so now there's going to be an instability in another part of your body that we're going to need to address, and this is something that we need to consider. And so for me, like, looking at it as an instability, like how can we mobilize the joint and get everything now to distribute that more effectively? This is taking on too much of the work, and so you may get some relief by then sort of dampening that signal by adding pressure, or, you know, sort of rerouting it by doing different types of movements to put a little bit more distribution of that force into other working muscles. So to really like light up and highlight other muscle groups to then, you know, take that balance back to stable the joint properly.
Well, let's take it to this person. It's their psoas they mentioned, right? I think, did I read that,
yeah,
right? Right. So she mentions the psoas, right? So imagine if you're, and you're both right in this, in the way you explain this, right? So I'm with Justin. Like, I think that this is always made a lot of sense to me. It's overactive, underactive. It's an overactive muscle. In other words, when you go to do a squat, the reason why you probably feel this in the psoas, probably on one side more than the other, there's probably somewhat of a shift in your squat. And it could be the slightest bit of movement. It could be all the way down to your foot. Right, your foot just barely pronates on one side more than the other. This causes some little bit of a shift when you're at the very bottom of your squat. When you have 100 pounds or more on your back and you're doing this for 5, 6, 10 reps, imagine how much more active that psoas has to be on one side versus the other. And so you're sending a signal to the brain like, oh my God, fire, 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 because it's having to take, it's not being balanced out in the body correctly. It's one side's having to fire and work so much more. That's why it feels that way after a workout. And the reason why a massage feels so good, it interrupts that, right? Mm-hmm. There's the brain's firing.
It's in a loop.
Yeah, it's in this crazy loop because it's like, holy shit, like she's making this side work so much harder than the other side. This isn't right. And so it gets in this state of like tonus, of like cramping up feeling. And then you doing pushing on it or getting a massage, it interrupts that communication between the brain and that muscle that's in that state. That's the way I would explain it. The way to improve it is what Sal said, is there's obviously some movement pattern that is not ideal and you're not moving optimally. Mm-hmm. So working on good joint mobility, taking the muscles through full range of motion without any load on it, just getting good at moving well. And you should, okay, and this is what I love about the Prime Pro webinar that Sal's referencing that I did. If you do that, okay, so if you've been someone who's lifting consistently, you're wise enough to point this out, you notice, you've connected the dots every time you squat or do these exercises, you feel it in your hip flexors or you feel it in these areas. Now I challenge you to go through those movements, especially the lower body ones in the Prime Pro webinar, go through those for a good 15 minutes before you go do your left and get back to me and tell me how much better that feels.
Yeah,
and you should feel it the first time.
100%. Yeah. And I'll say this, like this is 100% confident. With my clients, I solved 90%, I would say, at least of problems like this, whether it's my neck is tight, I have bursitis in this part of my hip. I have these knots on my IT band whenever I run. I solved a good 90% of people's problems or those issues with mobility and increased hydration. That's it. Those two things right there.
Yeah.
Hydration's another big one, by the way. Yeah. If your electrolytes are off and your hydration is low, your muscles are more likely to be tight.
Everybody knows that when you get that cramp feeling.
Totally. Yeah. Totally. Just I would just have people track their water. Oh, okay, now you got to have your drink about a half a gallon of water or a gallon of water every single day, and let's do correctional exercise. And no joke, of that 90% of people that I solved their issues, most of them, it took me a month. Literally, it would take me – like a real common one is neck tension. That's a super common one here in Silicon Valley. A lot of people working on their computers. And within a month of, you know, working on strengthening the mid-back, doing a little shoulder mobility, having them increase their water intake, they were always like, it's gone. It's totally gone. I've had this issue for years. So this is a problem you can fix. You just got to solve it. You got to solve the root cause. And doing massage and foam rolling, stuff like that, it Band-Aids. Can be a part of the solution. Temporary. But it's temporary. It's not really the main thing. And that webinar, again, is primeprowebinar.com, and it's totally free. I think everybody should go through there and try those movements.